exciting or tired? Tell me, frankly. Tired. See, we are on the same boat. We are on the same boat, but please believe me, take as much knowledge as possible. It will help you in the after 2 years. Now, before playing the guessing game, I want to tell you, we choose a little bit different topic. But if you follow newspaper daily for the past 2017-18, you know that topic because it shook the steel industry. Now, many of the people can guess it. So anyone guessed it? Great, man, great.
Good.
So let's start. Nikhil, please change. Now, downfall of BHUSHAN steel. Okay. Then now the next slide, please, Nikhil. Now the first question which comes to our mind, why we choose this topic? See, the objective is very clear. The steel industry is a rapidly growing industry. Like it analyzed that in by 2020, the production limit will reach 120 million tons. So what happened to this company? And the second thing, if you see the revenue chart, the company's revenue is in increasing mode. Then what happened again? And in the last is a failure story. So we should learn from it. Next slide. Next slide. Now, before content, sorry that we don't have any video, but we believe that human interaction is the best thing. So, before start, does anyone have any idea of this topic? Anyone know the reason? Anyone? Just one. Raise your hand. Anyone? Huh? Okay, great. So, it seems that you know at least 50% of this reason, but please keep your mind open. And let's start. Nikhil, over to you.
I think he has made our half work done. So, so during these 10 minutes, we will be discussing the brief introduction of the company, market share, competitive analysis, depth analysis, what went wrong, and the current stresses. And at the last, we will be discussing the conclusion. So, I hope we will try our best to get all of you to this topic. And starting.
This side.
Next slide, please.
Please change.
Starting with the introduction of the BHUSHAN steel, the company is founded by BHUSHAN Single in Saibabad. Actually, it acquired some ailing company in 1987. The company is currently has a 4 production plants in Saibabad, Khopoli, Odisha, and Hosur. And it is the 3rd largest secondary steel producing company in India. Mr. T.V. Narendran is the chairman and Mr. Raju Single is its managing director.
Now, coming to the market share, according to the 2018 data, the total market size of steel industry was 106.58 metric tons, where the major companies like Tata Steel acquired 12%, SAIL company, SAIL India, which acquired 14%, and JSW Steel, which acquired 15%, and where on BHUSHAN Steel only acquired 4% because it was going in debt loss. And if you must just previous slide, previous slide. Okay, you must worry about that other 42%. See, let me tell you, there are so many small companies who produce steel, okay, but they are so much tall, they don't even disclose their data in the net. So you didn't find this data, so that's why they are in the others part. Please change. Okay, now the competitor analysis. From this slide, we'll get to know two things. First, we can compare like Tata Steel, 60,000 crores revenue, 2018. Now, JSW, 71,000 crore, and where BHUSHAN Steel, only 17,000 crore. And there are many more other companies. Now, second things. See, in terms of revenue, market share couldn't find because there are no any perfect value for that. But if you add up all of this revenue of that, it will come around 3 lakh crore, okay, which is the 95% of total market share. Thank you. Next part.
So, before going to the in-depth analysis of the what went wrong with the company, I would like you to familiarize with the depth analysis of the company. Someone has rightly said that with the depth, company grow big fast, but when the bad times come, the debt suddenly become a massive burden. So that's the case with the Bhushan Steel. We can see in the facts that the debt, the debt to revenue ratio is continuously increasing in the consequent years. So to add on to this, the further reasons can be stated. The first reason is debt accumulation. The company's aspirations and the debts, increasing debts, was going hand in hand. The company still was continuously acquiring loans from various lenders, with a consortium of lenders leading with the State Bank of India, and to expand its present capacity. It took the loan from State Bank of India, Punjab National Bank, Canara Bank, ICICI Bank, Axis Bank, and the other lenders include various foreign banks, which include Deutsche Bank, Standard Charter, LIC, etc. The second reason is the failure in repayment of debt. Up to the year 2010 or the span 2006 to 2010, everything was going well because the company has invested and the steel prices are also low. But the problem started in the year 2010-2011 when the debt repayment obligation was suddenly increased beyond the operating cash flow. So that's led to started the problem for the company. And the third one is the global financial crisis. We all know the global financial crisis of 2008. The prices of the steel till half the 2008 was as high, three times as compared to the period 2012-13. But as India is a developing country, the continuous consumption of the steel is growing day by day. So there is an increase in consumption and the cost is going down. So that led to the problem creation for the Bhushan Steel.
Now coming to the fourth point, which is unable to reach full capacity. Now the company includes four firms. They have a production capacity of 5.6 metric tons. But in those past years, they couldn't even manage it. The average was always 2.5 to 3.5. So there's a lack in that. Next. Face loans. Now, let me start with a small introduction, examples, sorry. So, if a glass is full and we pour water on it, what will happen? It will overflow simply, right? See, same thing happened with this company. 2014, many lenders leading by State Bank gave them loan of 18,000 crore. And as a result, after 2 years only, the debt increased by 30% and incomes to around 46,000 crore. Next.
Now, what's the current status? Bhushan Steel Limited is owned by the Bhamnipal Steel Limited, a fully owned subsidiary of Tata Steel. It holds 72.65% shares of this Bhushan Steel. The settlement amounts equals to the 35,000 crore towards the financial creditors of Bhushan Steel, which was previous holding it. And now the Tata Steel for the future expansion is planning to raise the production capacity of the plant to the 4 metric ton in this financial year.
Now, at the conclusion, the main reason for the downfall is debt accumulations and bad managerial decisions day by day. Now, the global financial crisis also affected the company, which result is a downfall, and the company is a leveraged company. Now, meaning by leveraged company, like day by day, the company's debt increased, but the revenue not increased in the same way. So, thank you.
Thank you.